The vernier caliper, like any other, is a measuring instrument. This measuring instrument is used to measure small lengths like the thickness of a book, the thickness of a pencil, the external and internal diameter of tubes, and so forth. In today's video, we are going to look at how we use this vernier caliper to measure these things. This is Kisembo Academy, and thanks for tuning in. Right before us is a picture, a diagram of a vernier caliper. This is the vernier caliper we are talking about. This vernier caliper has got what we have, the inside jaws. These are what we're calling the inside jaws right here. Those are the inside jaws. Then we have the outside jaws. They are right here down. These are the outside jaws. Now, these outside jaws are used to measure external diameters. These inside jaws are used to measure internal diameters, like we are going to illustrate. Now, the vernier calipers has two kinds of scales. We have what we call the vernier scale and the main scale. Now, the main scale is this long one. It runs from zero up to the end. Looking at our vernier, looking at this here, our main scale, it runs from zero right here up to the very end, up to here. This is our main scale. Then the vernier scale is just down here. It is along this sliding jaw. We have this jaw. This jaw is fixed. This one is sliding. It slides along the main scale. Now, this jaw that is sliding, it has got some graduations on top of it. And these graduations are the ones that make up what we call the vernier scale. So the vernier scale is always the one that is sliding. The main scale, this one, is fixed. When we are taking measurements of a vernier caliper, we are supposed to read our main scale. Then afterwards, we read our vernier scale. And after reading our vernier scale, then we are able to add up the two figures and we are able to find the measurement. Now, in preparing ourselves to use this, we're supposed to first check the locking screw and loosen it. This is what we call the locking screw up on top. We're supposed to first loosen it so that this jaw is able to slide freely. This on top here is what we are calling the locking screw. According to our diagram, it is that. So you're supposed to first lock in that locking screw. Then now, before measuring, you're supposed to ensure that the calipers read zero when fully closed. Now, these are the calipers. Let's fully close them. When we fully close them and you bring closer, you're supposed to ensure that it is at zero. Now, at zero, if you can realize, if you see the vernier scale and the main scale, the vernier scale is supposed to be having the lower line of the vernier scale is supposed to be coinciding with the zero mark on the main scale. The first line on the vernier scale is supposed to be coinciding with the zero mark on the main scale when the thing is fully closed. Right there, it is fully closed. Then you're supposed to make sure that you clean the surfaces you're going to measure. Then afterwards, you take the measurements. For example, if I am going to measure this pen's diameter, I'm supposed to make sure that the diameter's surfaces here are clean, they are smooth. Then I'll take the measurement. So when I want to take the measurement of this pen, it is very simple. I'm going to simply get this, put these jaws, the outside jaws in between the pen, then I slide like that. Then I'll take my readings. This is a beaker right here. If I want to measure the internal diameter of the beaker, I simply take my vernier calipers. I'll this time use the inside jaws because I want to measure the internal diameter, and then I will slide like that. I make sure that the jaws have gripped this beaker. When the jaws have gripped the beaker just like that, then I can take the readings right here, the vernier scale and the main scale. If I want to find the external diameter of this beaker, I'm going to use these external jaws, and still I'll grip this in between, like this, right there. And then I'll take my measurements. So now we're going to look at how we take the measurements. Now when taking measurements, we have what we call the main scale and the vernier scale. So we first have to take the main scale reading. this line up here is going to represent the main scale reading. And by main scale reading, we are talking about the reading up on top of this scale. So we are going to take the main scale reading first, then the Vernier scale reading next. Now the Vernier scale is comprised of graduations or calibrations of points of gaps that are up to 10. So now this is how we do. We shall say main scale reading. So our main scale reading here is going to simply be, it's going to be, remember this is 20, 21, 22. So it's going to become 20, 20.1, 20.2. Now we are going to read our main scale in such a way that it is, we stop at the point where the Vernier scale begins from. This is where the Vernier scale reads. It starts from here, the Vernier scale. So where the Vernier scale starts from is where we're going to stop when you're reading the main scale. So the main scale is 20.1.2. So meaning our main scale reading is going to be 20.2. Then we shall go from the point where we stopped, which is 20.2, then we shall start our Vernier scale reading. We are going to count the number of gaps from here, from the first. This scale will read this is from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We shall look for a line in the Vernier scale. The first one that will coincide with the line in the main scale is the one we shall stop on now. If you look at the 0 line here, it's not coinciding with any line on top. You look at 1, it's not coinciding with any line on top. 2 is not coinciding with any line on top. 3 is not coinciding with any line on top. 4 is not. Then if you look at the 5th line. Now the 5th line is coinciding with that line on top. They are in the straight line. They are coinciding. So it means that we are going to read from 0 up to 5 as our Vernier scale. Our Vernier scale is 5. Now, our Vernier scale, its importance is to give us the second place of decimal. So, our first reading, the main scale, gave us 20.2. So, it means our second reading is going to be from 0 to 5. It's the fifth line that is coinciding with the line in the main scale. So, it means that our Vernier scale is going to give us to the second place of decimal. So, it means that here, if it is 5... we are supposed to multiply this 5 by 0.01 because it's giving us the second place of decimal. So it means as far as this is concerned, this is going to give us 0.05. And when we add up the two, it's supposed to be getting us 20.25 centimeters. And that is our answer. Let's look at another example. Still, we are going to look at the main scale. The Vernier scale starts from here. So the main scale here is going to be 10.1.2.3. So we stop at, if the Vernier scale starts here, so it means our main scale reading is going to stop right there, just before the Vernier scale starts. So our main scale reading is going to be 10.1.2.3. So main scale reading will be 10.3 centimeters. So then we go to our Vernier scale, and still our Vernier scale, we label this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so forth. So we're supposed to look for the line that coincides with the main scale, the first one. So if you look at the 0 line, it's not coinciding with anything up here. If you look at the 1, 1 coincides with this line on top. So it means our Vernier reading is going to stop there. And now it is 1. So it means that on our Vernier scale, it is going to give us to the second place of decimal. It means this is supposed to be multiplied by 0.01. So 0.01 times 1, this gives us our second place of decimal, which is going to be 0.01. And when we add up, we get 10.31 as our answer. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for tuning in. Up next, we shall be looking at how we use the micrometer screw gauge. This is Arnold Rangakuramia for Kisembo Academy.